The following show features thoughts, opinions, and statements by the individuals participating in the production for the sake of entertainment, and are not in any way shared by neighbors and friends or its sponsors. We in no way co-sign or endorse anything our cast members say or do. We're simply documenting a show, and our goal is to keep it as close to reality as possible.
Previously on Neighbors and Friends.
Racking up the points today.
Chase is in love, so his head's not in the game.
What are you doing to our teammate, bro?
If I catch anybody fraternizing with the captains, you will get a deduction.
I'm not fraternizing.
Don't total rip her up.
They're all bullying Austin when they're all disrespecting Kiki
on
every chance that they get.
People are accusing me of shit I haven't done. Hey!
Tonight is the
in sync
challenge.
I'm going home. What am I doing with my life?
Cause you're a bro.
Might as well, right?
You won't fight me cause you're a
All my friends are, they're on vacation, but I'm just stuck here in this parking lot. Well, I'm looking for a mirror, I'm looking at a screen. These pixelated dreams, I'm blowing up my pocket. I'll find some action, we'll cut the scene. I'm on a merry-go-round, I'm in a washing machine. Just spinning all of my friends, they don't do any favors. Unless they're partying, then they got all of them. All of my friends, they blow all of the paychecks. They've got no money, cause they're dumb and reckless.
Cause you're a bitch, bro.
Might as well, right?
You won't fight me cause you're a
imagine pressing another man that's not even f***ing near you.
No.
And not even talking to you.
No,
I have no issues with you. I'm not tight at you at all. Why do I want to fight you?
What reason? You are a bitch, bro.
He has a girl back at home. Ashley, I'm so sorry. I tried.
What do you want to say, Francesca? You haven't said anything all show. Make a name for yourself. What do you want to say?
Your girlfriend, Ashley.
My girlfriend? I don't have a girlfriend. You know that's fact.
That's fire. And McCall, you, because your girlfriend's about to watch this.
I don't have a girlfriend.
Your girlfriend.
You're going to be voted off tomorrow. Bye-bye. 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 You're useless. You're nothing to this show. Get off the show.
Cash. I love you. Okay, get the out of my
Get off the show in 2 days. You're nothing.
Kiki, go away.
Liz, I'm so grateful that you picked me to be on your team, because I said multiple times, Troy needs to be humbled. So let's get that dub.
Dubs!
We f***ing won.
Once again,
most likable person in the house. Everybody loves him. He's an icon. He will f*** anybody up, whether they're bigger than him or whatever. He still is him.
Once again, Dom straps up the backpack.
Again.
Takes the mic.
Thank God I'm on his team.
On his f***ing back.
Stop acting like you're a hard
You're literally useless to this show. You're doing nothing
you
for us. You have to. You have to do something.
Kiki, I will f***ing bump you.
Bumper. Do it. Bumper.
I can.
Like, you know she's my ex-girlfriend. She's not even my girlfriend. But that's how you want to act?
I'm a girl's girl. Like, come
You're not
on.
Even a girl's girl. None of the girls like you on the show.
All the girls f***ing like me. Cole, shut the up.
Guess what I've heard? None of the girls like this girl. They don't like her. She doesn't do anything for the team. None of the girls like her. I'll tell you right now. And I'll do a confessional.
Cut the camera.
I'll do a confessional with the four other girls. I promise you they'll tell you they don't like her. I promise. Confessional tonight, I'll prove it.
Other girls like me. She's like the anchor on our team. Not in a good way. The anchor dragging us down to the
her ground. And Austin. I'm about to beat Austin.
I don't think you should beat him. I just think they need to f***ing go home.
Tomorrow's elimination. They go home. I want both. Like right now, I want both of them to go home.
I'm going to f***ing finish out the night. I'm pulling all nighter because it's time for me to earn some f***ing points because my team f***ing sucks. Besides Sav and Taylor, I respect them. The rest of our team f***ing is trash.
No, you're crying. I don't want her to go home.
Yeah, well, I'm not sleeping on Saturday.
I'm not mad at you at all.
I'd rather go home than sleep on Saturday. I feel so dramatic. I'm sorry, y'all. I promise I will not.
We can watch three movies in here.
I hate that I love this.
Really, nigga?
We got you. Don't worry.
It's okay.
I can't sleep outside.
You're kicking ass. You're a bad ass. You're kicking ass.
Okay.
Everyone here loves you. Don't leave. Seriously. I would lose my shit if you left. Please don't leave. Please don't leave.
Yeah, that brother's starving.
Yes, sir.
I'm kind of
No, 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 no. Wait.
What the hell was that?
Austin. Once again, you f***ed us again, bro. You f***ing fell off the stage. Like,
I don't like to put blame or excuses, but 1-2 sunk. She's sleeping and that's all she does. Literally. Look at her, slumped.
But I'm here to win too, bro.
But you're like, not though, bro. You're not. It's just like, bro, you keep saying stuff, but you're not doing it. Our team sucks.
And I'm not gonna lie, like I'm not gonna hear. I'm not gonna
hear. No more point talking about it. We'll try to win tomorrow, see what happens, but we'll probably f***ing lose because she f***ing sleeps the whole time.
I fuck on that bitch and we lay up. I fuck on that bitch and we lay up. I fuck on that bitch and we lay up. I pass out like a layup. I trip with my cups like I had it. She come through late night on the Xanax. I tell when you back in that action. Like Mexicans. I sell them keys on the regular. I pushed out the car, it ain't regular. I'm watching my chain, ain't regular.
This is what she gets for embarrassing me the whole week.
I fuck on that bitch and we lay up. I fuck on that bitch and we lay up. I fuck on that bitch and we lay up. I pass her off like a layup. I trip with my.
Soon after.
Now that's cold. Why in the absolute would you use somebody else's clothing to clean up a goddamn spill, you stupid dumbass.
Why didn't you
say? Got it! Why the f*** would you use someone's clothing to clean up a wine spill? This is unfixable, you stupid f***ing dumbass. Before anybody tells you, I'm gonna tell you right now, that stupid f***ing and cut off hoodie and use it to clean up a f***ing wine spill.
Who?
Kiki. He ruined your
f***. Hey, come on. No, it wasn't. It was on a chair. I know where I put it.
I know. I was already.
Yeah, you picked up my hoodie and put it on the ground to clean wine up. Come on. Yeah, you did. Oh, you did it?
No. Who gave it to you? Who gave it to you? Oh, you don't know? You don't know? Thanks. Cap.
Do you not see the hypocrisy here?
I don't know what the f*** is wrong with y'all in New York, but like, we don't talk about people like that.
Does she technically identify as a woman? Or
she probably doesn't.
You stupid dumb. That's stupid. You stupid f***ing dumb. Thanks, Cap. Cap.
He's good. He doesn't hate you.
I don't hate you. Like, we're good. Chill out.
Girl, you built like a hot dog and a queso ball mixed together. Something wrong with you? You look nastier than a Chipotle bowl. You need to fix your shit up. Sweetheart, wake up and get your shit together.
When calamity overtakes you like a storm, when disaster sweeps over you like a whirlwind, when distress and trouble overwhelm you, then they will call to me, but I will not answer. They will look for me, but will not find me. since they hated knowledge and did not choose to fear the Lord, since they would not accept my advice and spurn my rebuke, they will eat the fruit of their ways and be filled with the fruit of their schemes. For the waywardness of the simple will kill them, and the complacency of fools will destroy them. Beautiful morning, get a sun in my morning,
babe. Nothing in the water. They tried to prank me, but I heard them talking like as I woke up. So I hid behind the door and I scared the shit out of them when they walked in.
What the f got us?
Just a little bit, give me.
Outstanding.
That's what happens when you fraternize. I told you. And you still lost 50 points.
What?
Yeah.
For what?
He was in the room.
It doesn't matter.
Crush my heart.
If you sleep with her in the same bed, it's 50 points. It was fraternizing. Fraternize. Associate or form a friendship with someone, especially when one is not supposed to. You, sir, lose 50 points.
I woke up in Liz's bed. I lost 50 points for that. And I didn't even hit. And I lost 50 points because I cut. I should go.
New day. Day three. Points are flowing. Wow. I don't even say nothing. Everybody
gonna say something. I'll be worried if they say nothing. 7 in the morning.
Straight to the f***ing dome. Oh my god. I wanna wake up with you in my heart. You're safe my morning
bar. Wow. Alright.
Good morning, Vietnam! No gay shit, we should probably take body shots off each other.
I did that off a dude last night. I just wanna feel liberated, I am. If I am instigated, I am sorry.
Tell me who ain't here to relate, I. It's cold, bro.
Was it worth it?
Was what worth it?
Fraternizing?
I literally was sleeping.
Doesn't matter.
Yeah, you could sleep anywhere. The one place you can't sleep, you slept in there. That's the definition of doing what you're not supposed to be doing.
That's fine. I'm not gonna do it again.
If he didn't get his nut off, that's just
a mess. That's sad.
Be honest. No. You didn't get your nut off.
I don't remember it.
Stop playing stupid! Oh, dumb
like, you woke up in her f***ing hoodie.
I can afford to lose those points because regardless, I'm not going home. And it doesn't f***ing matter. Because at the end of the day, we all know who's going home. Austin's going home. So, like, f*** him. I'll take the 50 loss. Guess what? It's 50 points that I didn't need.
Not me. Well done. That's so foul, bro. Game on, motherfucker.
Rise and shine, baby.
Time to wake up. My f***er is that I've been asleep for a couple hours.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, that was the one,
man. Oh. Doing today, I still have not gone to bed, and that means y'all have to wake the f*** up with me.
You want some food? Yeah. Guess who cooked you food and brought it earlier? I can put it in the microwave for you if you want.
Yeah.
Microwave?
You gotta sit up, though.
Can we bring you a bottle of water, too?
Yeah, stay awake. Stay awake.
Stay awake when we get back, bro. Just stub that f***ing slap more than 20 minutes.
Sure's rough. Sorry, Austin. Sorry, I think this is sad.
Come on, I need you to wake up. You need to wake up. Sit up for me. We gotta get you ready for the day.
Come on, Jesus needs you.
I hate this. Why the f*** did you convince me to pull a f***ing all night?
50 points. Chase
up twice on like Friday night.
Yes, Chase.
I don't know whose toothbrush this is. I'm so sorry. At least your breast smells more nice. So.
For points or just for fun? Yeah. Eat one?
Do not.
He's not even getting points for that.
It's day three already.
Yeah.
Day three? I feel like I've been here for a month.
This man wants to take my girl, bro. The one that I want from day one, bro. He wants to sit there.
Bro,
just do that.
No.
We asked her up there in the room, and you were like, "Did you come home to me?" She said, "No, you came home to me."
I just say that in front of you. I just want you to not f***ing lie. All this shit that I've been saying to you, and you've been denying because you're manipulative as f***. You need to f***ing tell the truth about me. Tell the truth, Nicole. Straight to the f***ing camera. Sav came up to me and started talking her shit first. Run it to Cole right now, straight to the camera. Look at it and tell the truth.
About what? I have no idea what he wants me to say.
No, I was trying to mackle Sav the entire two first days. We know that's how it was. Late at night, these motherfuckers disappear for like 2 hours. So I'm like, all right, I'm just gonna go for the next baddest one. Alyssa, but that doesn't take away from what you did.
This motherfucker told me exactly what started all the
what? I'm sorry that I funneled 8 beatboxes and don't f***ing remember everything I said word for word.
F***ing lies, bro.
When did you see me talk to Sam? Up until last night. Because every time I see y'all hanging, I see her denying you kisses and y'all just looking like friends. So I don't know if y'all really be doing this shit.
I was supposed to sleep outside. Troy was trying to get me to pull an all-nighter to get points. So Mr. Hardass, that's actually a softie, goes up to his car and makes me a hammock house. And we sat in the hammock and talked. That's literally it. We did make out, but that was literally it.
All right, how we doing? Looks like you guys had a rough morning. I saw a lot of all-nighters. How we feeling?
Woo! Chilling.
We got some business to attend to. The chopping block. We were supposed to have the two littlest guys and the two littlest girls doing this, but since Marcus decided to make it easier on us, we just have the girls one. So, without further ado, are you ready for the standings?
Oh my god, my voice is so
sick. So at the bottom two, we have Francesca and Taylor. Who wants to spin it?
Spin it nice and hard. Spin it nice and hard. Ball it is.
We are at the official first elimination of season 7. By the way, there's gonna be one later in the week, in case you guys didn't know. It's gonna go from 10 to 6 at the end. You think you're just gonna come here and get a free f***ing trip and stay in my house and give me no goddamn content? That's not how these things work. This is the first one, and then we're gonna have another one on Friday morning.
Jaleel.
Ready?
Yeah. Finna cry.
built. We gotta get Brandon on board at least. Get him.
First elimination was an absolute blowout. Taylor, congratulations for staying on the island. Fran, unfortunately, you're gonna have to get your bags and get to step in. Everybody else, we got a challenge in 30 minutes. So get back in there, get ready, beat your tire. The show must go on.
Let's go.
Let's go.
I got it. I'm sorry. I had to do it.
Very good.
I'm sorry, girl.
How are you feeling?
I'm feeling great. I'm not worried. Well, I'm a little bit worried because there's another elimination, but no, I'm happy that's out of the way. I was stressing for a minute.
Yeah, they're upset. We knew that was gonna happen.
I mean, we wanted to see a little more fight, but it is what it is. Come on, you don't want to compete, you're gonna get sent home.
My favorite part was you had the last point and you decided to stop. Turn around.
She was pulling
stiff
my pants
on her
down.
Nose.
And then she said, I'll give one more emphatic stiff on her to end this.
I'm serious. I don't think she was like trying. Like, I really don't think she like wanted to be.
Every person in this house put some type of disgusting substance in her hand.
Chips, eggs, pickles, everything. She's not showing up. She's got to go. You have to be feral. You have to be a dog, and you're going to be crazy. Couldn't even stay up with us and do it all matter with the team.
Yeah, instead she had to become a Chipotle bowl for everybody to look at.
12 seconds later.
You really regret it. Everyone loves you. Honestly, they've got to say you as a person. It's all good things to say.
So unfortunately, I'm going home. I'm pretty sad about it. I was here for the ride. I really want to keep partying. You know, I made quite a few friends, so it sucks that I have to go home. But I mean, I did my best. I tried, so that's all that matters.
Straight up, don't beat yourself up for it at all. You crushed it. Yeah. I said literally every opinion that I've heard so far is you're an amazing person.
Cap.
You killed it while you were here. Like I said, everyone loves you. Still, please don't be upset.
I'm good.
Okay. Love you.
Sorry, not sorry. And I was a hater from the start.
You called it. You actually did.
I really did.
Lost it all. Nothing lasts forever. Sorry, I can't be perfect. Now it's.
You know what? To be honest, Fran gave a lot more content and effort than Taylor has this entire week. But in the elimination, when it mattered the most, she didn't want the smoke. Some people just don't have what it takes to be on Neighbors and Friends, and she's one of them. Oh well, we'll give you a D plus. Good luck with Mitchell Musso, though.
Upon the beach of South Padre, where the waves crash and roll, there's a game played with heart, mind, body, and soul. It's called the Oklahoma Challenge, a test of your might, where players face off and competition ignites. Two players, one football, a battle to the end. Let's see who's for real and who's really pretend. After all matchups, there can only be one. The contestants who fought in two rounds and who actually won.
Gotta win this competition. Who am I tackling? Who am I body slamming to the ground today, motherfucker?
I'm coming in at 125 pound deficit for this challenge. The odds are not in my favor.
The alliance is broken.
Our alliance is broken.
Done with this alliance.
She let me down.
Hi, Dad. I'm sorry. Broken. Tom's funnier.
Hey, come here, Alyssa. Come here. This is my new alliance right here. Right here. This is my alliance. We're taking over Pitt State.
I need to go wash my face, but someone just took a huge in the bathroom and I can't even get close to it because it's stinky. Is it still smelly?
I just...
I'm actually gonna puke.
Why?
From that I'm gonna wash my face in the f***ing pool. Day is young.
Ah, marooned yet again. Thank God this boat's full of my new canned fizzy sangria. And one industrial satellite phone.
3 hours till pickup, Joe. Hang in there, buddy.
Send the slow helicopter, please.
Joe, can you hear me? A lot of people are worried here, Joe. Are you there?
Welcome to the day games! Get ready for the Oklahoma Drill Challenge. This is a solo game that starts off with a shotgun coin toss to determine if they want to run the ball or defend. Contestants will then line up on opposite sides of the arena with their backs to the ground. When the whistle blows, the runner will stand up and attempt to get to the other side and pass the goal line. If they're successful, they win the round and move on to the next one. But if the defender can stop them, they'll win. The next round is the championship round, and the winner of that will receive first place and 30 clout coins, while the runner-up will get 15, and get to enjoy a free lunch at On the Border Mexican Grill. The losers get nothing and must spend the afternoon cleaning up golf carts.
All right, thanks. Stay on defense and then turn on offense.
the best New Yorker win,
Long
baby.
Island, Buffalo. Let's see who's better.
I'm a sore loser. I'm going to give it to you. What are they going to say? Shouldn't have said that. Okay. You guys want to be boring? Let's all just have an easy round. Everything has a piece of cake. No, everyone wants, this is what people want to see. I'm not going to sit there and be like, lost. No, bitch, I'll still stop you. I don't give a fuck.
Vegas versus the two tiniest.
Tiny but mighty, right?
Oh my god, please stop saying
that. I didn't say it.
Stop saying that. Please stop saying that.
That motherfucker is like, had over kills for you in the last
24
hours.
Really? I was sitting there like, I
don't know.
I might move to Texas.
Chase,
but you're speaking
crazy. That's how he is, bro.
So
I thought he's that
type of
guy.
He's a dancer.
What do you got, fucking pixie dust in between your legs or what?
Just been her
bodybuilder.
I am. Am I the only one that has acne?
Yeah.
Did you not Zach?
No.
You're not the only one.
Yeah.
Bro, true. Like
that. Forgot about y'all two over here. First night.
Dude, we're keeping it low key.
No, it's not low key. That. Everybody knows.
Everyone knows.
Oh my god, we've been here before.
Yo, what happened? Got lost a little.
Sadly.
So you're gonna clean up the golf carts, wipe them down, make sure they're squeaky clean, and then if there's any bathrooms or anything, then you're gonna do that too. Let's do the golf carts first.
I said certified freak, 7 days a week. Wet ass pussy, make that pullout game weak.
Hey, all 40-something be clean.
This is so gross.
Yeah, you fucking with some wet ass pussy. Bring a bucket and a mop for this wet ass pussy.
Rivalry started.
I was not trying to. I was letting you have that. She came up to me and said that. I did not make a move at all. She said it to me because she chugged AP boxes. Troy, you gotta back me up.
Saab did look at me and say,
yeah, she picked him.
I didn't do shit.
She came up to me while I was sitting at the table.
She's also at the bar talking to me like, you're hot as f**k, I want you. It's a rivalry, bro. It started.
No.
Because I had alliance with her first, and then you stole it. So I'm going to come for you next. Savannah does have a thing for like skinny white boys with issues that look like they're not going to amount to much.
That is my type of thing.
She told me last night like, she has daddy issues. Every girl with daddy issues looks for dickheads like me.
Guess what? If it don't happen on the show, she's coming to Dallas. She already said it.
Everything you got, put this wet ass pussy. Beat it up, nigga, catch a charge. Extra large and extra hard. Put this pussy right in your face. Swipe your nose like a credit card. Hop on top, I wanna ride. I do a kegel, one is inside. Spit in my mouth, look in my eyes. This pussy is wet, come take a dive. Tie me up like I'm surprised. That's role play, I wear disguise. I want you to park that Big Mac truck right in this little garage. Make it cream, make me scream. Out in public, make a scene. I don't cook, I don't clean. But let me tell you, I got this ring.
Double beer ball, look at this.
No, double.
Hey, watch this.
It's following you around.
It wasn't me, dog.
Gobble me, swallow me, drip down inside of me. Quick, jump out for you, let it get inside of me. I tell him where to put it, never tell him where I'm about to be. I run down on him before I have a nigga running me. Talk your shit, bite your lip. Ask for a call while you ride that dick. You really ain't never got him fucking for a thing.
If I was a golf cart, I'd beat this one right here. We actually gotta make her cute.
Tuition just to kiss me on this wet ass pussy. Now make it rain if you wanna see some wet ass pussy.
You guys did a little bit of work, got a little elbow grease in there. Personally, I wouldn't let you guys go. I think you guys need more work, but it's not up to me. We gotta ask Tony, what do we think? We letting them go, we gotta stay.
You can let them go. I mean, they did a hell of a good job. Not the best. Next time, go fuck up so you don't have to be here. Next time, it's gonna be worse.
Let's get your asses out of here. Get back to the house.
Check it out, you got me mesmerized. With your black hair and your fat ass thighs. Street poetry is my everyday. But yo, I gotta
got my dark liquor, son.
155.
What is it?
210, y'all.
Oh my god. Oh, he got money. Dom just spent my budget for the whole week in an hour.
We can get down. Now let's knock the boots like the group H-Town. You got BBD all on your bedroom wall. But I'm above the rim and this is how I ball.
Today was insane. I just went ham.
Unfortunately, I lost again. You know, Adam won once.
I don't care what everybody else says, but Kiki, she tiny, but she mighty. I don't care. Everybody else said, I'm not about to say that anymore. But Kiki, tiny, but mighty.
I was scared my knees were gonna buckle. That was my biggest fear, is that my knees were gonna invert and break. And that'd be so embarrassing.
I knew I was gonna smoke Austin. And then I knew I was gonna have to go against Cole.
I'm not making excuses at all. But if my ankle was better, he wouldn't have won because I took him out. Like, messed my back up. Like, f***ing hurt. He's a big boy. He's a tank.
Defense wins. You don't need offense. Who cares about scoring points? You don't need to score points. You just gotta f***ing defend your goal, your whatever the thing in football that goes like this, whatever that is, defend it. Don't let anything go in it. Like, nothing goes past Kiki.
I had a game plan for Cole, but as soon as I turned around and look at that big body coming towards me, everything went out the window. I just scrambled.
I kind of knew I was gonna dominate because I honestly like feel like I'm the most athletic out of all the girls. It was me versus Alyssa, so I beat her. And I thought she was going in for like a hug, like, oh, like good game, whatever. She's like, what the f- is up? Just starts popping off, grabs my ponytail, and pulls me to the ground. I was just genuinely in shock. It was bizarre.
So I obviously lost, and I was a sore loser. I got shoved to the ground and got so annoyed, even though it was a game. Like, in my head, like, it wasn't processing anymore that it was a game. Like, I just got shoved to the ground. Like, there's no stopping me. Something slipped, flipped the switch. I don't care who you are, we're on great terms, but once I got body dropped to the ground, I was like, oh, hell no, like, I'm not getting dropped to the ground. I'm embarrassed. But then I made it even worse by like hitting her, but no regrets, and I thought that it was funny.
This went a little too hard. I love you, Liz. You went way too hard, baby.
I literally don't care who you are. I'm not getting shoved to the ground on TV without smacking somebody after.
I'm very happy-go-lucky, very chilled out. It takes a lot to make me angry, but like if she does that shit again, I'm not gonna know what to do because I will get angry and I'm not gonna just sit there and not defend myself like I did this time.
It was not even intentional. Like Taylor, if you're listening to this, you have done absolutely nothing wrong to me ever besides beat me in that competition, push me to the ground. So like I just have to give a little bit of entertainment. But love you, girl.
"500 pieces of weight on two tables, a picture to form, a feat to enable. Eight contestants will stand eager and ready to solve their puzzle and drink their Borg steadily. Each piece connects as the liquor flows. The race is on and the energy grows. The first team to finish will claim the prize, but it won't be easy as the alcohol flies."
Alcohol flies.
Woo!
Borg.
Borg.
Shot. Cheers, y'all. I did this last night. I got it down, but this one is gonna be tough. I'm not gonna lie.
Now you got it. Good game.
Digesh! I have to do something. I'm sorry. I love you.
I'm a good person, I swear.
You're making mama proud.
I gotta go. I love you.
All right. Love you, bye.
Just like that.
Hello? Hey, it's Austin.
I know.
Oh, really? I thought you f***ing deleted my number.
Last night I got f***ed up, and I was just thinking about you.
Aw, oh, that's cute.
I miss, like, the times we like, spent together.
We haven't talked in, like, 3 years.
I know, because you got a boyfriend.
Not anymore, though.
I mean, I just want to let you know that I still love you.
When I come back home, we definitely gotta, like, hang out or something.
I'll talk.
She's good. She's good. She always asks about you and stuff.
Let me go though because I'm going for a jog. I love you and I'll talk to you soon, all right?
Bye.
Bye, bye. Go, bro, that's...
Liz comes and is like, hey, I have this thing that I got from some of my regulars. She works at a bar. And I'm like, what is it? What's up? It's called Horny Honey.
I've taken it.
You took it before, bro. Tell what happened.
I've taken it prior.
I'm experienced it. I don't know what's gonna happen.
I took a whole package to myself. Let me tell you what. This works. It works.
You don't really know what it does, but I guess we'll wait and see.
I have my one.
Dude, that looks like.
It tastes like honey.
Last time I ate a whole package of that, my joint did for 4.5 hours.
I took it about 30, 40 minutes ago. Not gonna lie, this is crazy. Like, no cap, bro. Like, I can't even think about anything else. I'm just horny as f.
And now, we're about to take you through a whole week to show you the real meaning of neighbors and friends.
Been for God.
not Joe. I've been married a long time ago.
Starting to look like I might have to lose 100 points at some point.
Oh my God.
At some point.
There you go. Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe?
What's up, you little boot scooters? Take your mask off.
Yeah,
we're here at Longboard Bar and Grill, and this is the Smorgasbord Challenge. Make some noise, motherfuckers.
Welcome to the night game. Get ready for the Smorgasbord Challenge. Each team will be given a 500-piece puzzle, and each contestant will be given their own personal 1-gallon Borg, filled with water, beatbox, and a splash of vodka. Whichever team finishes their Borgs first, and has the most pieces of their puzzle connected after 1 hour, will receive 40 clout coins and a prize package from our sponsors at Yifno. The losers get nothing, and must sleep outside for the night.
Explore your future.
You guys gotta put your little brains together, drink as much as you can, as fast as you can, and finish this puzzle as fast as you can as well. Let's get it going.
No need to rush. This puzzle, take your time, think it through. If you rush, you're gonna fuck up.
Corner pieces always help first. I would say have two people working on the edge, two people working on the center.
Don't out-drink yourself, don't out-puzzle yourself. I don't know what they're gonna do, I don't give a fuck what they're gonna do. So we're gonna win. Taylor, we need team chug right now. Team chug.
Oh, hey, I heard a puke.
Who puked?
Who puked?
Oh.
Someone
puked.
He's out.
The main characters of this episode are... Between pulling an all-nighter, deviously stealing Savannah away from Cole and racking up fuck it list points to take the number one spot away from Chase, Dom really bossed the fuck up and put on a show this episode. Gotta give props when they're due. Taylor crushed Fran in a full-on blowout to eliminate her ass, dominated the Oklahoma Challenge, beefed with Alyssa, then let Chunks fly at the end there. So it's gotta be her. Too bad the 50 points cancels out for bragging about fraternizing with Troy. Don't let it happen again.
Episode of Neighbors and Friends.
I like the direction you're heading, bro. Yeah.
So Kiki and Austin tried to f- while I was sleeping.
There was whipped cream.
I'm like, actually about to lose my f***ing mind.
It's all a mental game.
What the hell is even that?
The slam bag challenge makes some noise. We got the Buddha's Buds Fine Art Challenge.
Adios, Taylor. I'm not gonna miss you. You're sneaky.
I can't stand someone that can't f***ing say it to people's face. I slapped you, and guess what? I'll do it again.
I'm probably gonna get knocked the f*** out. I'm gonna get raped back up, and I'm gonna keep running my f***ing
run. Tom. Yo. You mad at me for something, bro?
My team disowned me today, because I'm on top, so
show.
I've been watching from day one. I like remember I was applying and shit when I was 17 years old. Like, yo, how do I get on the show?
I found it on TikTok when I was like 19 and I DM'd the Instagram. I was like, how in the gift of God do I get on the show?
That was a great first round. Shut the fuck up. Why are you peeing on the floor, you fucking scumbag?
What's up, yo?
Look at us. Oh. Someone get him off me, please.
If you enjoyed this episode, head to neighborsandfriends.com to check out our previous 6 seasons. Plus, we have season 7 uncut with no censoring. Special shout out to all of the fans who support this show. We're 100% independent because of you. Follow us on YouTube, TikTok, and Instagram for more content and updates.
This could be our best disaster.